you for coming to church, everybody.
It is the fourth Sunday of October, better known as Boctober, because IBOC is celebrating 31 years of ministry, and we are loud and proud about IBOC and the University of Dreams.
Here are your trending topics for the week.
We have been in school for 10 weeks now, and today we want to shine a spotlight on our toddler class. Sister Fight and Sister Vincent lead this group of potty training miracle babies, and they spend all day learning letters, colors, shapes, and Bible songs with hands-on activities. We love our toddler scholars, and Sister Fight and Sister Vincent, you're doing a great job.
Shout out to Deacon Carlos Lynn.
Deacon Carlos Lynn was a part of history this weekend. The Cedar Hill Longhorns played Duncanville in the first ever football game at Globe Life Field, and even though the Longhorns did not win, Coach Lynn is still impacting the team and the community in a positive way, even to the point where the band paid tribute to Coach Lynn at halftime. Look at that. Keep your head up, Coach, and thank you for all that you do.
Shout out to Sister Sean Baden.
Sister Sean Baden is a loud and proud IBOC member. She is a fantastic singer, and she's a professional in the property and casualty insurance industry. She recently attained a top and most recognized credential in the insurance industry, known as the CPCU designation. It requires years of studying and several national exams, and she was victorious. So congratulations, Sister Sean Baden, on this professional achievement.
And our final shout-out goes to a young lady by the name of Sister Emma Haynes.
Sister Emma Haynes is a loud and proud IBOC member. She is a proud supporter of U of D, and this weekend she turned 80 years old. And you know what the Haynes family did?
Here he comes, here comes.
They rented a slingshot, and Sister Emma Hayes just cruised around town with her hair blowing in the wind. Her daughters are Sister May and Sister Ravlin, and they are also loud and proud IBOC members, and they do a great job of taking care of mom. So happy 80th birthday, Sister Haynes, and let me borrow that car after church.
Ghost Eraser, Ghost Eraser, go!
Heaven and nature sing.
Calling all IBOC teens, IBOC young adults, and IBOC youth. We are in the planning stages of an IBOC Christmas production, and we need your help. So if you are interested in helping us out as an artist, orator, writer, musician, mime, actor, actress, social media enthusiast, singers, dancers, rappers, choreographers, publicists, costume designers, prop experts, set and scene designers, stage managers, technical light and sound teams, service project coordinators, program book graphic designers, or program book editors. We need your help. It's going to be amazing. We are just going to give God the glory in a fun, creative, fantastic way. And we need you. So get ready, because next Sunday, we're going to give you more information about an IBOC Christmas production. And don't forget about Dream Church tonight at 6 p.m., Monday School tomorrow at 7 p.m. After service, we are celebrating October birthdays with cupcakes from the restaurant. And, of course, Brothers Don't Sleep on Men's Fellowship every Friday at 7 p.m.
Those are your trending topics for the week, so have a blessed Sunday, and all the glory goes to God.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and today we would like to showcase a brief testimony of a loud and proud IBOC member and a loud and proud U of D educator who refused to give up. This is her story.
Hi, family. I'm Sister Sonia Golden, and I am a proud member of the Inspiring Body of Christ Church. And since this is Cancer Awareness Month, I thought I'd share a little bit of my story with you. In 2016, 2017, I became the University of Dreams educator. Thank you, Jesus, for my job. Also, 2017 was a little different for me. My brother died. I was diagnosed with high blood pressure, and I had a swollen gland that they had to remove from me, and I was also diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer in 2017. Yeah, it was a little different from me. I had 9 surgeries. Parkland gave me 11 pair of socks, that's how many I counted, and 9 of them was from the surgeries that I had. I give God all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor, because no matter how many times Satan threw that cancer stone at me for those 9 surgeries that I had to go through, God still gets the glory, because I still woke up every day with my dance on, y'all, because I love God and I believe him and I trust him, and I trust him because of the man of God that he has said before us, Pastor Rush. He taught me in this building, I believe, we were having tithing your time, and one of the sermons said, you don't have to die. So from that second on, no matter what happened, I was good. So I wanted to say this to you. If you're going through anything, if you think you're going through something, I found out because I did a breast exam on myself. Do your breast exam. Go to the doctor. Check yourself out. Don't give up. Don't quit. Don't let Satan steal your joy. Keep your peace of mind. Give God the glory. Keep coming to church. Keep paying your tithes and offering. Keep doing what you know God wants you to do. Pastor Rush, I thank you so much for everything that you've done for me. To God be the glory. Bye, y'all. Enjoy your day.